Hi guys, this is JJ. Happy Sunday. This is your Oracle message for this beautiful evening. If you come across this video, then you were meant to hear this message. Remember that these videos are intended for educational purposes to help you apply to everyday life and help you heal and work through your obstacles. So we have three cards here, or three options, and this is from the Alchemy deck from the Wild Unknown. I also have several decks here, and whatever I feel called to or pulled to for each particular pile, then I will be pulling those. These I do read from the guidebook, you guys, because I just love the guidebook and it has so much juicy information. So like always, these are general readings, so take what resonates and leave the rest behind. Something doesn't fit, do not force it to fit, just let it go. That is it. So I will see you in your selected pile. Remember that all my services, or how to contact me, or if you want to book something a little bit more personal, all of that is always in the description box below. Thank you to all of you who signed up for the Super Blue Moon, which the cards are blue, so maybe this is a message for you. And this is going to be August 30th when the super blue moon happens, and it's going to be in the sign of the mystical Pisces. So let's take a look. Let's see, what is your Sunday Oracle message? Hello, pile number one. Let's see, what is your Sunday Oracle message for you guys? I hope that you guys are having a beautiful Sunday and that you are enjoying with family, or Monday, wherever you are in the world. But if you came across this video, then this message is for you. So let's have a look. Let's see. Sorry for any noise in the background. It is Sunday, so my complex tends to be very noisy. We do have here Virgin's Milk, and it's blue. So I do feel here that this full moon in the sign of Pisces on the 30th is going to be significant for you guys. Blue roses, I feel like communication, clarity, truth. I associate a lot the color blue with Mercury. So I do feel here that there has been a lot of releasing. There has been a lot of emotional purging, if you will, happening here. Something is budding in your life. Something is blooming in your life. Something that is in alignment with your purpose, with your North Node. I feel like this is something that is going to make you very happy. This is something that's going to bring in a lot of nourishment and a lot of fulfillment here for you guys. At the bottom of the deck, we do have Metamorphosis number 22. So again, the 22 to me is all about, is a master number, but it's also a number that represents balance, harmony, unity. It represents a balancing of masculine and feminine energies. I feel like for many of you, you have been, because this is at the bottom of the deck. So I do feel like this is a change that you have been going through, that you yourself have been kind of like really getting through this metamorphosis, this change. I feel like there's going to be more fun. Look at that. You might be seeing 222 a lot. Right underneath, we have another two, which is Fun Flamingo. So I do feel like, you know what, the heaviness or the thickness of this change, of this metamorphosis, it's done. I feel like now you guys are kind of like just getting used to who you are becoming and what your new life is. And so, you know, allow yourself some grace while you do that. You might be seeing a lot of monarchs, or you might be seeing a lot of flamingos lately. I don't know. Maybe you went to San Diego. I don't know. That came to mind. But we have here obstacles. Yeah. So for some of you, like I said, these challenges, this change has been difficult. It has not been easy. So I feel like the energy is going to get lighter for you guys. I feel that maybe for some of you, you took a road trip, maybe to a mountainy area, or you're about to. Yeah, number five. I feel like this change has been challenging here, but I feel like there is a smoother road ahead. I feel like spirit is like guiding you through this big mountain, this big challenge, this big obstacle, if you will. Let's see. We have koi fish. So maybe you saw koi fish today, or if you're on my personal IG, then you probably did, because I did post pictures of a koi pond that I went to visit today. Yesterday, sorry. It says prosperity, good luck, and celebration. There's a lot of good things coming into your life, okay? Your guides are saying, we know things have been tough. We know things have been difficult for you, but you have to believe that things are going to get lighter for you. Things are going to start working and falling into place for you, especially financially for some of you. It says koi fish symbolize prosperity, good luck, longevity, abundance, and perseverance. If koi fish has swum into your life, it is a sign of great fortune. It's coming your way. You'll be glad you didn't stop swimming in the direction of your dreams, even when you felt the current was against you. You are rearing a time of happiness and celebration. A shiny koi fish swims to you and opens his mouth to reveal a golden pearl of abundance. Do you accept it? So again, your guides are saying, yes, things have been difficult. We're not denying that. Things have been quite challenging for you. But I feel like things are going to start flowing more easily your direction. And I feel like particularly in regards to your finances, in regards to your career as well, and maybe even in relationship here, because we do have two koi fish. Again, two. The number two is significant here. Either your birthday is on the 22nd of a month, the 2nd of a month, or you've just been seeing that number a lot. Roses too, okay? Whether that be red roses, yellow roses, white roses, the color doesn't matter, but I am seeing roses being significant, and I will be reading this from the guidebook, like I said in the beginning, but I'm just picking parts here. Yeah, it's kind of this energy of like you have been having to be a chameleon, okay? You have been adapting a lot, pivoting a lot. And so it's like now you're growing into this new skin. For many of you, you let go of a toxic relationship. You let go of something that was no longer serving you. And your guides are very proud. Your ancestors are very proud. And they are wanting you to surrender to stress, to relax a little bit more, to trust that this change is positive. That even though right now you might not see it that way, it is. It is positive, and you're going to start to see it. Because many of you, you did let go of a unhealthy relationship that keeps coming up. Or an unhealthy work situation, just because, you know, there's many of you who watch this. There was something toxic here that you had to let go of. Wow, the spiral. Look at that. So maybe you resonate here with the, I cannot say it. I cannot say it. I'm going to butcher it. But you might resonate with this, with the life force energy. I feel like life force is coming into your life. You've let go of a lot of deep-rooted cycles. You might have had a Kundalini awakening as well here. Pile number one, the spiral. Yeah, you've another five. The synchronicities here are crazy. I feel here that there is, it's like you're stepping into a new vibration. And every time we're doing that, you know, things aren't easy. It's challenging. But you've made it. You've done it. You're doing a good job. So, you know, hold on. I know it's been tough. I know it's been crazy. But your guides are saying you're doing an amazing job, okay? And good things are coming your way. So let's look at this card right here. Let me read it for you guys before I close the reading. That is the Virgin's Milk. So it says innocence, naivety. You guys know I butcher everything. Purity. In alchemy, lac virgins is a mystical substance supposedly coming from the virgin's breast. The alchemists ask, how can it be? How can milk come from one carrying a child, from one not carrying a child? That is precisely the nuanced teaching of lac virgins. When studied as an alchemical concept, it points to a lack of awareness or experience that the alchemist would rather not reveal. Yes, this milky substance is a symbol of purity and innocence, but its shadow side is naivety, and even denial. When the virgin's milk appears, discernment and honesty must be applied to the work. It is something being glossed over, rushed, or presented as perfect. There are likely complexities that need to be addressed so the alchemist can gain the maturity to handle what's next. Watch the movie The 40-Year-Old Virgin. That's what they recommend. To ponder patience as the remedy. Just one drop of lac virgins can be medicinal. It can help the alchemist act as if know your measure. So what I'm getting with this is there's something here. This change, this metamorphosis, you might be seeing a lot of, like, specifically the monarchs. Whatever this change was, whatever this metamorphosis was for you, you needed to gain experience in order for you to move to the next step. Because if you didn't have this wisdom, if you didn't go through this, then your guides are saying it was going to become even more difficult for you to get to the next stage, okay? And so, you know, you working through these complexities, you working through these challenges actually is giving you the wisdom that you need for what's to come. And here there's also something that, like I said, especially those of you who left a toxic relationship. I mean, Venus retrograde came in to sweep everybody's relationship, or like shake everybody's relationship. It feels like here your guides are saying there were certain things that you needed to let go of, that you were just kind of glossing over. And maybe for some of you, it wasn't leaving a relationship. Maybe it was something at work. Maybe it was something in the relationship that we were not addressing because it was easier for us to just gloss over or to just pretend like, okay, that's not a big deal. But actually it was. And so it needed to be addressed, or it needed to be discussed, communicated, worked on. And so that's why your guides are saying this metamorphosis, this change needed to happen. That's why these things needed to come up. And even though it was challenging, even though it was difficult, just know that better things are coming. And for some of you, it was at work. Maybe there was something at your work, or in your business, or in your career, or in your, I don't know, whatever it may be, that wasn't working for you. And again, you were just trying to push through. And your guides are like, nah, we're not doing that anymore. We're not glossing over this situation. We're addressing it. Whether that be because, you know what, I was okay with working so many hours. And your guides were like, no, you're not. Stop saying that you do want to work that much. Or stop saying that this situation was not bothering you, or that you weren't passionate about this, or your current job, whatever it is that you do. It's like your guides are like, no, we have to be honest with ourselves instead of glossing over it, instead of just pretending like it doesn't bother us when it did. So fundamental changes needed to happen here, pile number one. But just know that you're now in your new skin. Now you know what you want. Now you know what you like. And amazing things are coming in. Starting off with wealth of all kinds, prosperity of all kinds as well. And for those of you who are seeking a relationship, that is to come. And those of you who are or have been working a lot of things in a current relationship, then, you know, your connection is reaching a new level of commitment. But that is what I have for you, pile number one. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. Bye. Hello, pile number two. Let's see, what is your Oracle Sunday message, or your Sunday Oracle message? Let's have a look. Let's see what is going on here. Yeah, I hope you guys are having fun. Like I said, in pile number one, it's probably going to be noisy here in my complex just because it's Sunday and everybody's home. So if you hear any noise in the background or any kids laughing in the background, kids are being kids and they're having fun. And that's always the best because that means that they are healthy. So let's have a look here. We have Benevolent Guide. Ooh, I love this. You might be seeing a lot of bees, maybe rainbows here. Could be. Bees always remind me of sisterhood, brotherhood, right? This energy of community, this energy of healing, of sweetness, this energy of hard work as well. This energy of money too. I think I said that, but just in case I didn't. Let's see. I feel like for some of you, there is a guide stepping in to your life, whether this is a new guide that just stepped in or is about to step in. But this feels like this is an actual guide, like a person, like an earth angel, if you will. That's what's coming through here, the lower world. Okay, they're helping you get through something here. Something that is a little bit like a shadow. This person might be coming in October 31st. I don't know why I got that, but that's what I'm getting for you guys. It's kind of like you guys have been doing all the heavy, heavy shadow work. Because the lower world to me, it's all about this energy of, in a way to me, it's like the past. Okay, so maybe you've been working through past events, past wounding, or maybe you were just living in the past and now you're stepping into the middle world, which is the present world. This is the world right now, you know, the 3D world where you're kind of like where everything with your work, everything here. I feel like you're okay. They're saying you're becoming more present, you're becoming more aware. Now you're ready to get back here in the middle world and start like working on that foundation here. Because you've been doing a lot of, I want to say, reflection. Reflecting here is what's coming through. Drums. Maybe someone bought drums recently. Because I am picking up drums. There was a lot of like, ghosts from the past. Okay, thank you. They're saying that you were addressing a lot of ghosts from your past, whether this be people that came back, that is Mercury retrograde, or whether this is just your own ghosts from the past, right? Things that you had to kind of address here. There is something that you had to let go at some point because it was not divine timing. This message has been coming up a lot recently. Even on Patreon, there's this message of like, now it's divine timing for you, pile number two. There's a lot of things that you're like, I wanted this once upon a time, or I wanted this in the past, and now it's showing up, and your guys are saying yes, because now it's divine timing. And I feel like a lot of this information, or a lot of this knowledge or wisdom, is coming in from a very unorthodox guide. I don't know why I'm getting that. Pay attention to animal guides too that are showing up in your life. You might be noticing that a lot of animals are attracted to you a lot more than usual. Whether this be insects, I know those are not fun, but you know, it could be cats, dogs, things like this too. But it's like bees maybe like flying over you a lot more, or beetles, because that's what I'm saying, that there's like a June beetle outside my window. So pay attention to the animals that are showing up. We have surrender to the inner peace, cultivate inner peace on a daily basis in quiet meditative moments, focus on the stillness within and enjoy the inner refuge. Others will feel your good vibes too, and your life will flow more easily. Yeah, maybe you're drawing more birds to yourself too. But again, it's because now you're at peace and you have surrendered to your soul's path as well. That's why everything now is happening in divine timing. For some of you've been waiting for someone. You've been waiting for someone, because I'm seeing the beloved. I'm hearing the beloved. You've been waiting for someone, and it's been a long time. Or you've been wanting something to happen in your love life, and it's like now it's coming in because now it's divine timing. It's like you had to let this go. You had to trust spirit that they were going to bring it in when the time was right. I'm sorry. Let me get a card that fell here. Yes. Oh my God, divine guidance. Who is this guide? But I feel like even if it's not a guide, you guys, this is someone. Oh, I love this. 33. Pile one got 22. You guys got 33. Master numbers. This is beautiful. You might be seeing 333. But what I was gonna say is, before I deviate, because I tend to do that a lot. Even if this is not like a physical guide, you're receiving a lot of divine guidance in regards to something in particular in your life, and it's going to be different for everyone. It's like now you're seeing everything. You're seeing all the synchronicities. You're seeing like, and it feels like it's something from the past, something that you wanted from the past is now coming in. It's like a wish, if you will, with a star here. Like the holidays. Pay attention to the holidays. Those are going to be big markers when this divine guidance comes in, because I am seeing 31 being Halloween here in the States, and then we're seeing 33, or just a Christmas. So Christmas again, these holidays are going to be significant for you guys. It's like I feel like, regardless whether this is an actual person, an animal guide, or just signs, whatever it may be, in whatever form that is for you, it's like you're receiving this message of possibilities, endless possibilities for yourself. And it's because you're trusting now, is what I keep hearing here. And there's a lot of peace coming into your life now. There's a lot of peace. I feel like you're due for that. You're due for that peace. You're due for that happiness now. It's like, it's about time, JJ. That's what I keep hearing. It's about damn time. Okay, let's see. We have closer than you think. Something is closer than you think. And for some of you, it's love. I kept seeing that. You might be seeing hummingbirds a lot. Again, with the mountain, spirit is bringing this. It's been difficult, you guys. It hasn't been easy. It's been challenging for the collective for the past few months, I want to say. A lot of emotions, a lot of releasing, especially things from the past. A lot of wounding has been coming up. So if you've been part of that, just know that you're not alone. There's a lot of us, myself included, that were in that kind of took a hermit mode and kind of just, I had, you know, you had to kind of go within and just take care of you, do you kind of thing. But the card says here, faith, keep going, a surprise. Spirit has a surprise for you. And I feel like, again, the holidays are going to be significant. And also there's going to be more peace, more sense of security and stability just because of all the red and the root chakra that is here. And then we have here in the back, it says, it's often the times we are ready to give up and lose hope that what we are seeking to, or what we're seeking to, is right around the corner. We can only endure pain or disappointment for so long until our hearts get filled with doubt. Though the times we feel the heaviest, like we can't take anymore, are often just times of emotional purging and are followed by a period of healing, grace, and peace. Positive change, rewards, and feeling lighter. What is it that you're passionately seeking, whether it be inner or outer wealth? This card is a sign to not lose hope and keep moving forward in the direction of your dreams. That which you have been seeking is closer than you think. Yep, it's closer than you think. It's right there. I feel like something was right under your nose and you just couldn't see it. That's kind of what it feels like here. And I feel like you're going to start receiving this like divine guidance. Yeah, it's like your view of life. There's something about your view, your perspective also that is changing here. And that's the reason why you're starting to see like, oh, you know what? Yeah, it is possible. Yes, it is possible for me to believe this or to trust that spirit is going to give it to me. Okay, let me read the card here, the benevolent guide. Yeah, because many of you have been doing the soul retrieval. The soul retrieval here. That's why you've been in the lower world. That makes perfect sense. Maybe you've been working with Quetzalcoatl or with the snake totem as well. Okay, let's see what we have here. Okay, benevolent guide. It says inner voice, guide, and ally. Pay attention to those downloads, that inner voice that keeps telling you the same thing over and over, and you're just like, huh, that thought keeps coming back. Yeah, it's coming back for a reason. It says, oh, how easy is it to doubt the presence of the spirits? The alchemist, falling into a moment of forgetfulness, feels alone in the laboratory and begins to doubt their work. Disarray and discontent follow. What do I listen to? Where do I turn for guidance? All the while, the benevolent guide hovers close, waiting to be acknowledged, waiting to be heard amidst the noise of the world. It appears words of kindness and encouragement into the ears of the alchemist. When this card appears, it asks us to recall the guidance we have received at important junctures in our life. That benevolent present is constant and not conditional. Now is not the time for structure, for struggle or fear. Soften into the gentle humming of the wise bee. You cannot make a wrong choice when this spirit guide is near. It says, read the poem, I Am Not I, by Juan Ramon Jimenez, and to ponder the wind as messengers. So let me leave it here in case you guys want to read it. Pause it. 11:11, as I said it. Yeah, it's like I said, there's something you were not aware of, and it was right there under your nose. It was right there. Maybe you're recalling a lot of information too, and this can be information from past lives too that you're now implementing. But beautiful things are coming in for you, pile number two. And yeah, be excited. Be light with the hummingbird, okay? I feel like here there's a lot of like solar plexus energy as well with the hummingbird. I feel that there's going to be more confidence for you. There's going to be a lot more happiness as well, pile number two. So do not give up. Do not give up, because things are about to turn in your favor. Bye. Hello, pile number three. Let's have a look and let's see what is your Sunday oracle message. Most likely when I post this, it will be Monday. So happy Monday. But let's have a look. Let's see what is going on. Let's see. I'm so excited for you guys. What do we have here? Chiron. We've been seeing this energy for a long time. We've been seeing this energy of, let me get situated here. It's like the energy of Chiron has been coming up for many of us, both in Instagram and in Patreon. There's been this heavy healing here, and I feel like pile number three, you guys have been doing the inner work. Maybe you're like me and you have Chiron in Cancer, so Venus transiting, being retrograde in the sign of Cancer, maybe made some aspects or maybe touched on some Chiron wounds there. And so for many of you, it seems like there was obsessiveness. Ugh, I got itchy my... Okay. So maybe money, something about money. There's money coming in for you guys. Pile number three. I love that. Something with your hands, okay? Maybe a skill that you have or a skill that you're developing. But Chiron, so like I was saying, that was the wounded healer. So for some of you, there were some aspects or maybe you are going through a Chiron cycle right now. And so I feel like Chiron is all about those deep wounds within us in our chart, and it reflects that and it lets us know. And so, you know, maybe you have Chiron in Leo too, because Venus was retrograde in Leo, Cancer in Leo. And I feel like these were heavy wounds. Like, these are not easy wounds. And I feel like you guys are ready to teach this to others. That's the reason why you had to go through that, this Chiron activation, if you will, this Chiron reflection. It's like you had to look at your wounding, because I feel like pile number three, you guys are my healers. Chiron, you guys are my healers, my star seeds, with whatever label it is that you yourself identify with. Whether it be starseed, earth angels, whether it be the rainbow, crystal children, like, or witches, or whatever it is that you identify with. It's like you have this healer energy to you. And there's something about the woundings that you've been working through that were meant to make you aware of something, because you're ready to teach it. You're ready to teach it. And for many of you, you weren't even aware of what these wounds were until now. Because this is also like past life healing as well. Yeah, this is all in divine timing. Like, everybody and every pile has been getting this message of divine timing. It's like spirit saying everything that is happening right now is divine timing. And I know usually that's all the time when we're in the present moment. But there's something about things from the past, or things that you're like, why is it being wrapped up now? Because now is divine timing. There's a big emphasis on that. So it says sometimes divine timing may differ from your ego's timing. If a goal isn't manifesting fast enough, according to your ego, be patient and trust the universal flow. I feel like here you had to surrender attachments to something. Like, you had to let go. You had to make peace with something, is what I'm getting here. Your Cancer might be in a water sign, like I said, or maybe a fire sign for some of you. Whatever this was, it's like it was affecting your stability because of this heavy root energy. Yeah, it's like spirit put you on a pause, pile number three. It's like you had to replenish yourself. You had to replenish. You really had to be in the present moment. So if you have, and I hate to say this again, but if you're like me and you have this Chiron in Cancer, Cancer is all about your inner world. It's all about your emotional energy. Oh, beautiful hummingbirds outside my window. And that is related to the, to me, it's related to the... to the sacral. It's like being present in the moment. But like I was saying, with this Chiron in Cancer, it's like you had to go within. You had to take some time for yourself. You had to take like a break. And maybe you're still taking breaks. Maybe you're now doing things at your own timing, you know, things that are just in the flow right now. And your guides are saying that is what you're meant to be doing at this time. Because I do feel like you guys might be, and this is a message that has been coming out on Instagram a lot too, you guys might be my my generators. And so you have to do things in a sense of like when you feel it, you know, in your passion, when you feel it, when you're in the flow. Okay, let's see. Surrender to trust. Yeah. So trust yourself and your decisions. Don't be swayed by other people's strong opinions about what to do. Take action and be confident that you have chosen the right path. So for many of you, you have been making these decisions and now you're kind of questioning. You're kind of questioning, like, is this the path for me? Is this, did I make the right choice? Am I making the right choice? Your guides are coming in today on this beautiful Sunday to let you know you are making the right choice. Whatever brings you happiness, whatever feels right to you, that is the right choice. Don't doubt yourself. Don't doubt your wisdom. Don't doubt your own experience either, okay? But it's more important, bless you. Sorry, my kitty just sneezed. But it's like, don't doubt your own sense of timing too, you know, your own flow. If you don't feel like doing something today, like let's say for example, like if you're a content creator or something like this, right? Or you're like, no, I don't feel like being in a relationship right now. Or, you know, it's like, okay, well then trust that. Trust your own timing right now. That's important. You have to trust your own discernment. And even if other people are telling you like, no, that isn't right. Or no, you know, what you're doing doesn't seem right. Or, you know, if I were you, I would do it a different way. And it's like your guides are saying, you got to follow your own flow right now. Especially if these opinions are coming from family or they're coming from people that you admire and that you respect. Always follow your own intuition. Then we have here Angel Oak, healer, roots and wisdom. Like I said, with the Chiron here, this makes perfect sense. You guys are my healers and you guys are tapping back into your roots and you're going back. Maybe for some of you, you're stepping into shamanism. Maybe for some of you, you are going back to your ancestry line in some way here. You're learning about it. It's like you have so much wisdom and that is that Chiron energy. And that's why you need to trust yourself. The card says, God has fertilized the seed. Now all it needs is to be showered with earth, with faith, and observe the warm rays of divine promises. Yes, you are awakening, but you are still buried beneath the surface. If it feels like blossoming is taking forever, it's because you are slowly growing strong and mighty roots so you can grow into a strong and mighty tree. The oak seed does not force itself into growing. Effortless, it grows into its natural giant and ancient blueprint. The oak is a symbol of strength, wisdom, and healing. You are in the process of awakening to your dormant healing abilities in a whole new you. But the wisdom you need to get there will come through just being, and it's coming through your Chiron. Look at your Chiron placements. It says here, we may spend endless amounts of time, energy, and money on self-help books, gurus, and all forms of guidance through nothing seems to help us breaking the surface. These things will do no good until the precise moment nature decides it's time for you to grow another branch of awareness. This card is a confirmation to allow yourself to dwell in the dark, rich, and nourishing underworld. So your roots, you probably are coming from pile number two, because pile number two, we did get the underworld card. Like I said, there is something here that you're learning and you're going to teach it to others. Okay, so these are my healers. Or even if you're not a healer, like let's say in the traditional sense that you're out here on the platform or something like this, you're still teaching others and you're going to guide others. And again, everything is happening in divine timing. And for many of you, you're already coming out of this, like being in this womb, being in this like void energy. And for others of you, you're still there, but you're about to. And like the card says, doesn't matter how many books or gurus you listen to. At the end of the day, you got to listen to yourself. You got to listen to your own inner voice and you have to trust yourself because your path is yours and it's nobody else's. Pile number three. It says, when the raging storms of change come ripping through the forest, you will have learned to bend and not break. You are blossoming into the best version of you, yourself, and all of creation. Your wisdom that comes from experience versus others' beliefs will help other seedlings to grow towards the warm sunlight of their true beings as well. You are destined to be a great healer in all that you do. So like I said, you have to follow yourself and you have to follow your own rhythm. Okay, if something doesn't feel like you know what, I don't want to do this today, like, you know, share this today, or, you know, practice this today, or whatever it may be, listen to that, because there is a reason for it. And you're meant to be an amazing healer, but right now you're healing yourself, okay? And you're gonna take that wisdom and share it with others. There's a new adventure. Just let go is what I'm hearing. Pile number three. Whoa, sorry. Let's see. We have hope. So don't lose hope during this time, especially when you are working through this cycle right now. And whenever we're in the void, just know that I know things can get a little dark. I know things can get a little blurry and we might not be able to see, but just know that there's always hope that the sun will come out, okay? For you. And the doors will open when they need to open. And then we have here bees at the bottom community. Who else got bees? Pile number two. So maybe you guys are coming from pile number two. Yeah, they got this one. And it's coming out again. Or maybe you just went to go get some coffee. I feel like you're receiving a lot of messages through insects. That's a big one that's coming through for you guys. But I feel like you guys are gonna strengthen your community, the people around you. You guys are like this big oak tree that's going to shelter and provide shade for others. And we have here lightning. Yeah, it's like a big shakeup. Here we see the silhouette of a person. And this person is being like hit by lightning. And that always reminds me of this Uranus energy. That always reminds me of the tower. It's like a big awakening. I feel like pile number three, this is your biggest awakening yet, is what it feels like. It's gonna be big. And it's because you are tapping into this Chiron energy. And there's so much expansion. There's so much life force here. There's so much abundance that is coming in all forms. Your future is bright. Your future is bright, so don't let unhappy people dim your light, is what I just heard from spirit. Okay, don't let unhappy people, yeah, because you're gonna be, I feel like you're gonna be, and I don't, sorry, I have to give this message, but I feel like you're gonna be attracting, because your light is getting bigger, you're gonna be attracting like naysayers, or you're gonna be attracting these other people who in some way are gonna question your beliefs, whether they know this consciously or unconsciously. It's like it's gonna put you in a place of like, oh shoot, am I doing the right thing? Am I not? And as your guys are saying, these are trickster energies because you need to learn to trust yourself and trust your own decisions and trust your own truth. But that is what I have for you, pile number three. So again, I know things have been a little heavy. I know there's been a shakeup here, but things are about to. It's like you're breaking the glass ceiling here in some way, and you've been healing a lot. So don't lose hope. But that is what I have for you, pile number three. Take care of yourselves. Stay safe. Bye.